We are gonna look into a mod I never played before. I know the mod was a massive, massive thing in Hearts of Iron 3. It's a mod that is full of air boost. It's a mod that is very, very in-depth. People are telling me it's the most realistic take of World War II. Welcome to Black Ice. We aim to bring Hearts of Iron 4 to an all new level, making your game experience more immersive, historical, and challenging. Black Ice completely overhauls most national focus trees, changes game mechanics, adds in tons of events, technologies, units, and much more. PP, stability, nothing new there. That shouldn't be too overwhelming. Does Argentina have a focus tree? Let's take a look. It doesn't. It's okay, I just want to learn for a second. I like how the bonus is so smaller. You see it's only 25%. Oh, fuck, they have these shitty NATO symbols. Oh, can I turn that off? You can't turn that off? Oh, fuck. But this is very understandable. So we have headquarters now. Militia, garrison. Okay, very in-depth. Obviously, we have production, which looks... That looks actually really cool. I like this. We have trade, obviously. We have diplomacy, intelligence, obviously, and decisions. Nothing crazy. Decision-wise, we have propaganda. We have... I can do operations. I can do political stuff. I can do foreign influence. Okay, there is a lot of laws and ministers. So, let's take a look at the most important thing here. I have debuffs here, but the debuffs are not shown here. Research center locations. What? So what is center of? It doesn't really matter. Okay. Can you change the images individually? That's a good question. I was in the army. I don't understand this stuff. If you click the default symbol... I broke the game. Easy peasy, Alto. Get shit on, developers. Infantry. Infantry starts with rifles. Infantry guns, uniforms. Dude, I think this is amazing, man. Mortars, dude, you have... I like this, dude. Cavalry equipment enables cavalry horses and headquarters. Cavalry detachment. Then you get a motorized command. This is headquarters stuff. Then you get new weapons. You could make, for example, an infantry truck platoon. So you can kind of choose what kind of weapon you have. Bazookas, night vision, goggles, garrison equipment. Enables a garrison. Then you have an infantry gun, which is a support unit, I guess. You have uniforms. I think this is great. So building a division must be very crazy here. And specialists. Support units. You obviously have support equipment, which leads to reconnaissance. You can get engineers. Yes, we know that. You have cars, which helps. The cars are meant for MPs and maintenance. And you have infantry trucks for logistics, radio, and... Okay. Artillery, just probably like World War Bra. You have anti-air. You have horse transport? You have light artillery, medium artillery, and heavy artillery. I get it. Okay. You have arty spotting planes. Oh god, what? You have railway artillery? Jesus. You have rocket arty, okay, and anti-tank. I still fucking get it. What the fuck? Then we have cars. Armored cars, which is reconnaissance cars, like normal. Light vehicles and a tankette. Armor tech, tank designs. So I can't really make real tanks. And before I have to fucking design them. I unlock stuff and then I design a tank. What is the new DLC? I have $5,000 before and no one ever played this one in multiplayer. I wonder why. Probably because the PCs die on this. Great War Army Doctrines. This is... You can do all of them. You have infantry. This is pre-war stuff though. You have artillery doctrines. They're all not exclusive. You can take them. Battlefield support. Early air theories. Mobile. And you have World War II, which you can't take because... I already unlocked asymmetric warfare, which is very small. Command? Alter, what the fuck, Junge? Okay, that is a lot of doctrines. Navy. Yeah, uh-huh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Then we have destroyers, cruisers, submarines, battleships, and carriers. Really in-depth and shit. And we have the doctrines. That looks... This looks, at the moment, just like a Battlehoy 4. Air. We have fighter interceptors, which is... I like how it always says what it is, like Fighter 96, Inceptor, Multi-Role Fighter. There's so much different equipment though. Heavy Fighter, there's CASP and Bombers. That's just not so crazy. Air Doctrines haven't been changed. The developers were like, fuck that. And then we have much more in-depth engineering. Very cool. That gives stability. That is so cool, man. And my favorite, obviously, Industry, which looks... What? It sucks you can't zoom out. That's a bit shit. You can't zoom out the focus tree. machine tools, quality control, what kind of industry you want, construction bonuses. You build sieves slower? Wait, civilian fuel consumption. Are you telling me a sieve takes fuel? Hey, what the fuck? So the research tree looks great. You have infrastructure, air, anti-air, phylactone, which is stronger anti-air? Yeah, it's stronger anti-air. Radar, supply depot, takes up to 1 week to activate, can only be built once per region. Decreases supply consumption in this state and by neighbors by 10%. That's big. That means if Germany goes into Russia, you should build depots, which is really makes sense. Police station means less resistance, and research centers provide your nation with resource slots that can be gained by focuses or events. The minus 30 probably means my debuff right now, I guess. Armored vehicle factory. They just reduce costs. For example, if you're an infantry guy, you should make a small arms factory to reduce the cost on infantry equipment. Why would I need a storage? I just don't trade it away. In Black Ice, you need to store resources. So, listen to this. If I would buy 10 aluminum from the US that I'm not really using, this aluminum will now go into a storage, which at the moment is zero. I have to build one. Then the war starts. My trade is getting intercepted by submarines, but my airplanes that need aluminum are still building until the storage is empty. That's actually genius. That's very high IQ, but genius. That's okay. That's like old world goose. Looks pretty fucking epic though. So far, I got the basics. Apparently, this is a picture of Dank is getting vaccinated. What was the headline? 10 of Spammer gets vaccinated? This guy says, if I research an anti-tank gun, all my infantry needs suddenly anti-tank guns. That makes no sense. If I never add an anti-tank gun, that makes no sense. I don't understand that. For example, say machine guns. Introduces heavy machine guns to the following battalions. That's a bit stupid. You should give the player the opportunity to design his own stuff. If I want a division without machine guns, I should have the right to do that. That's a production line. That's a production on its own. Oh, that's massive. Every time I do this, I literally have to join that. I have to make that. Oh, this is like Hearts of Iron 2. These two slots are for everything, and this slot, this research slot, can only research infantry and support. And why is artillery grayed out? This is only for Navy and this is only for air. Okay, I'm learning the game is Canada. Fuck this. Alter Schwede. Garrison mate, Alter. Oh, that's a bit much. I always ask for more equipment, but now I'm like, oh god. Oh my fucking god. I literally asked for this yesterday. There's a difference between submachine guns and machine guns and rifles. Whoa. What is an artillery truck? Do I need that later? I don't know. I don't think this mod is canceled. You guys are very negative. I think once you learn this, it's actually good. The question is, do you want to learn it? Maybe it's time to get into doctrines? Is special forces a full doctrine? I'm doing special forces, thinking it's a real doctrine. No, they all work parallel to each other. As predicted, this is very overwhelming. I need light vehicles and motorcycles. Hey, this is... My brain is slowly coming to the conclusion that I don't like this. It's good, it's just not my cup of tea.
I said so, I told you, Tommy, I told you.
Yeah, man, good job, you're a genius. I'm calling Black Ice here. In no way, shape, or form do I think Black Ice is bad. It looks amazing. It looks like a mod made for people that want the hardcore experience, people that loved Hearts of Iron 3, which I really didn't. We are switching to a different mod, a Warhammer 40k mod, the Unification Wars. Earth looks very different, okay? This is 30,000 years from now, I think. The Emperor of Mankind is with us, and he wants to reunite Earth. Fortress of the Sigilites. Oh my god. As you see, the world is barren, right? After thousands of years, the world is just so full of fucking war and everything is trash, man. Nobody's happy anymore. This is what happens when you eat meat and drive an SUV. We are the Emperor of the Magistris Temporal. The aftermath of the Age of Strife. The Age of Strife has left our country shattered and our population has been slaughtered by the millions. There was an Age of Strife which fucked the human race up. So we have Age of Strife armor. I can't even move this. No, I can't. We have pattern bolter, support equipment, custodian armor, trucks, and heavy mortar. How many melts do I have? Okay, that's all my melts. Let me take a look at this first. It's all held very basic. Most importantly, this game should be completed by the focus tree. Many people say this is a very disappointing mod. Let's check it out. Here we have the little mini focus tree. Let's see. And we're doing the beginning. The Emperor has been alive for thousands of years, but he never showed himself to the human race. He was always just watching and plotting his move and shit. Many people discuss how the Emperor was made, and listening to Lua Tin, he thinks that back in the olden days of, like, our age, like, in old Egypt and shit, there were so-called shamans. And the shamans were the first ever individuals of the human race that kinda were psychers. They could, like, oh, there's more out there. Oh, there's the warp. There's a different universe. Oy, oy, oy. And these shamans were so clever and enlightened that at some point they got depressed by this shit in a way. They would suicide, but they knew they would always get resurrected. After many years, all the shamans on Earth were kind of bored of this stuff. So they all died or killed themselves. And then all their spirits, this is not confirmed though, came together. All their power came together. And then a new individual was born called the Emperor of Mankind. An uncertain world. My time is coming. The Emperor of Mankind is coming. The Sigilite. An old man has come to me, offering his services to me and my cause. Many have come before me with such offers before, often in the pursuit of power and wealth. This one is different. Is this Malkador? He's a legendary human who saves the human race and shit. The Sigilite is upon us! Brave men of the Imperium! A presence has entered this palace, one stronger physically than any here. Sefrai. I left without a word and arrived at the Eternity Gate, still under construction. He's building the Grand Palace of the Imperium, because he knows he's gonna make a big empire in the galaxy. From the very first moment of our meeting, the mutual understanding was between us. He knew that I was much older than I seemed, and I knew he was older than he looked. Oh, Malkador was also very, very old? But above all, our sheer psychic power was beyond anyone on Terra, and perhaps beyond any throughout the galaxy. And though he was a secretive and rather cryptic, I knew his plans and intentions for humanity were noble. He spoke.
I wish to serve at your side, my lord. I know you will not refuse me.
Malkador the Sigilite enters your service. He's an advisor now? The signs of my coming have been numerous. The village people speak of fresh golden water pouring from springs unflowing for generations. A young girl is not sick anymore. So in a way, I'm slowly showing myself to human race. I'm showing that I'm gonna save me, like Jesus Christ in a way. The Emperor was hiding in a hidden cave system under the Himalayas, where he did something for thousands of years. What did he do there, Chet? Two men born anew, designed to be the pinnacle of human strength and power. To the first, I bestowed the name Valdor, and the other, Taranis, Kasudis, and Kategis. They are the first of many to come. They are the first Space Marines? I didn't know. We ought to raise 100 regiments to support our effort of unifying Terra. Let's create an army. Okay, also let's get Malkador Sigilite, the greatest man to ever live, man. This is too complex. Where is Aragorn and Legolas?
He is here. The eagle is here.
Eagleborn are next. I gain course on them and load order of the battlefield. The Emperor of Mankind has revealed himself. It's time to unite. I annex the Dragon Kingdom and I get course on it. Building a kingdom, boys. Eagle warriors have joined us. The first sons, the first Legio Custodes are recruited. They're not yet Space Marines, but these are kind of superhumans. They're really strong. Look, they even have armor and shit. Can I get war gods? Let's send an ultimatum to all the tribes of Himalaya. If they want to fight, we can fight. I have people now. Oh shit, I don't know who these people are. Constantin Baldor. Damn, he looks fucking cool. Aggressive assault, offensive doctrines. Look at this guy, man. That's the first legion. Let's take Arik Taranis. Okay. What's up, dude? The Order of Taranis. Okay, oh, is that fucking... A lot of people accepted me, a lot of people declared... Oh, what? Oh, wait. I'm at war with these Easterners. Onward, my brave soldiers! Show them who we are. I also have computers now. Epic. I think the developer mostly focused on the focus tree and not really on the research, I guess. The Emperor's Refuge, brothers! Give me all your equipment, bitches. Let's do this, the Genos soldiers. I'm not gonna read that, man. I'm doing Genos soldiers. I'm getting a lot of equipment, man. Dude, we just fucking annihilated them. Once again, in the lore, I just have insane soldiers, man. Welcome to the Empire, bitch. Kingdom of the Himalayas. I get more Legio Custodes, and I get massive infrastructure in all of the Himalaya. Let's go. First unification. The Himalayas are now under my dominion, now and forevermore. As I look south, beyond the slopes of the great mountain peak, I think of what shall come next. This is but the first step towards rebuilding the Empire of Mankind. The Empire crossed all of the Himalayas. The first Thunder Warriors are recruited. Unlock spread the Imperial Truth decision. The Imperial Truth is his religion, aka there is... Religion is bad. Nobody should have any religions. And only logic and reason should be number one. My name is True. I am the Emperor of Mankind, and my age has begun. You are now known as the Emperor, and the first Thunder Warriors are recruited. Dude, 24 Thunder Warriors. Oh, I have the new picture now. The Emperor of Mankind. Okay, let's get Space Marines, man.
Yeah.
I mean, why is Warhammer 40k cool? Because of Space Marines, right? Without Space Marines, this will all be fucking whatever. Biotechnical Division unlocks the Astartes program. Researches Mark II power armor for Thunder Warriors and Astartes. Okay. There should be an event. Where the fuck's my... So there was 20 legions, right? The Emperor made 20 Space Marine legions. Each different because it uses different genetical seeds for them. Like, for example, the Lunar Wolves, they have, like, wolf genes and stuff. By our estimates, the program will be completed in 100 months. Requisition Bolter Reserve. What? Recruit volunteers? Contract scientists? Gene seed research. I'm working on building Space Marines. Whoever made this mod, I just want to enjoy the mod real quick right now, but this is a beta mod. This feels really weird. You just press weird buttons and shit. It's really awkward right now. So obviously this mod still needs a lot of work. Dude, let's go back to war, man. The border set. The Himalayas are under my dominion, and now I shall march forth into the rest of Terra. To the south lies the land of Ind, dominated by petty kingdoms and lords. Let's kill them. Warhammer not based since women can't be Space Marines. Do you have any thoughts? I will listen to that. I was listening to an audiobook the other day, and they say women are not allowed to be Space Marines because men have more muscle mass. What? What? I'm gonna get banned. And the gene seed that you implant, it doesn't work. Let's kill Palas, man. Let's go. Let's go. Peaceful unification. Let's try that. I'm meeting with him. I will bring order to this broken earth. A lot of lore is happening right now. I'm talking to kings and I want to kill them or something. Yeah. He said no. So watch this. Begin regional tithe thing. What does that mean? The Angels of Death. The First Legion Angels of Death. Space Marines, man. These guys are just like heavy tanks. How does that work now? I just press train? I just train what I want? I'm just getting fucking Space Marines like crazy. Oh god, that feels really unfair. Yeah, I'm unbeatable now. Space Marines, GG, man. Okay, I kind of feel like I've seen everything this mod has to offer now, man. Now you just take over the world. Not much more happening. I'm not going to judge it. It's in beta stage. Obviously, this mod is not going to rank high. It's not beating any of the big mods. But I wanted to have a little check into it. I wanted to check it out real quick. Show some Warhammer lore, which I'm kind of into lately. But yeah, overall, just very, very undone. Yeah, that is the Unification Wars mod for Hoi 4 Warhammer 40k. Still a lot that needs to be done. Very unfinished, but could be something one day. I'm gonna rank it on the bottom, but I'm gonna be nice. It's in beta stage.